Supposing we take motivation. Motivation can be an independent variable, but it can also be a dependent variable. It becomes a dependent variable. When we, for example, use what are the motivations to learn? What are the factors that you might consider? Again, we might say compensation. Promotion. Confidence in work. Confidence in one's work. What else? Recognition. Now this might be your independent variables. So if you look at this, and you look at this, this is only one. Okay. Now, if your motivation is very low, is it affected by this? What are your scores in all of this? This means that you have to develop scales to measure this so that it can now be compared, motivation as a dependent variable. So what is a dependent variable? A dependent variable is the variable of your primary interest. In other words, this is the most important variable to you. This is what you want to learn about. The researcher's goal is to understand and describe the dependent variable, or to explain its variability or predict it using the independent variable. So that is your dependent variable, the one that is affected, and that is what you are interested in. Okay? Now what about the independent variable? Then, the independent variable is generally conjectured that influences the dependent variable in either positive or negative way. You just say it is influenced or affected, represented by this arrow here, which is very important. But you really don't make mention at all whether it's positive or negative. You just show it. You don't know whether the influence is positive or negative. Does compensation increase motivation? Hoping that you will be compensated if you go for training, you will be given a raise, promotion, will it increase your motivation? Will confidence in your work increase your motivation to learn? Or will recognition increase your motivation to learn? So those are all your questions, because your conjecture is the independent variable will have an effect on the dependent variable. Now you don't know whether the effect will be positive or negative. That's not your concern. You will only get to that when you develop your hypothesis. Okay?
Cái independent variable này là cái biến số ấy là cái biến số nó không bị ảnh hưởng bởi biến số khác, biến số độc lập ha. Thì các cái biến số độc lập này giá trị của nó sẽ thay đổi, và khi nó thay đổi nó sẽ ảnh hưởng tới giá trị của biến số bị lệ thuộc là biến số y, giống như cái y và s cộng b kia các chị nãy giờ cũng nói rồi ấy. Thì khi mà nó ảnh hưởng với nhau như vậy thì thường nó có ba ảnh hưởng là positive, negative, tức là sự cộng hưởng kéo cộng hoặc là dấu trừ đi ngược lại chiều, hoặc là không có ảnh hưởng gì với nhau cả, là số không, tức là tùy theo cái sự ảnh hưởng của nó thể hiện ở cái hệ số a, tức là nếu a là dương á thì là positive, a âm là negative và a là số không, mà giữa hai cái ít nó không ảnh hưởng gì với nhau hết. Nhưng mà chúng ta thì giờ không có biết được là nó đang là mối quan hệ positive, negative hay là số không cho đến khi chúng ta đưa ra hypothesis và bắt đầu đi testing nó. Bây giờ nó chỉ là hai, chúng ta chỉ biết là nó ảnh hưởng lên nhau thôi, chưa biết ảnh hưởng kiểu gì. Play ăn mặc thôi.
Dạ,
đúng rồi.
Lúc đó mình sẽ đưa ra học cho sếp, mình sẽ bắt đầu trả lại và đi kiểm tra. Còn tại thời điểm này thì chúng ta chỉ biết là à, với biến số Y là motivation, biến số bị lệ thuộc là motivation là Y, nó bị tác động bởi các biến số là compensation là lương, promotion là sự thăng tiến, và cái recognition là được nhận thức ở công ty rõ ràng hơn. Đó là những cái biến số không bị lệ thuộc. Mời clear không ạ? Chị Hà sao?
Okay. Clear? Okay. So that, those are the dependent and independent variables. You're saying that for any change, whether positive or negative, on the dependent variable, the function of that change is from the independent variable. The independent variable will not change in your particular study. It's the dependent variable that will change, based on what you measure in the dependent variable. Okay, it is generally to establish a change in the dependent variable causes a change in the dependent variable. All of the four conditions should be met. There are four conditions that you should meet. One is that the independent and the dependent variable should co-vary, meaning a change in the dependent variable should be associated with a change in the dependent variable. In other words, your study and all your reading should lead you to believe that independent variable and the dependent variable should co-vary. In other words, if this one changes, this one will change. That's one. Okay? Clear? If there is change in the dependent variable, it is because there is change in the independent variable. In other words, for your population, for the people that you try to inquire, or the respondents, the samples that you get, an increase in this independent variable will also result in the increase of the dependent variable, or vice versa. The decrease in your independent variable will also mean or cause a change or decrease in the dependent variable. That means co-vary. They come together, they change together. So that's one requirement for the change to happen. The second is the independent variable does presume cause or the factor that causes the change should precede the dependent variable. In other words, it should be here. That the independent variable can never be here. Clear? Because this one should come first before the change or the dependent variable could be there. Okay, that's the second requirement. In other words, there must be a time sequence in which the two occur. The cause must occur before the effect. Of course, the cause should be there before there is the effect. How can you get an injection for dog bite if you have not been bitten by a dog? Right? So you have to have the cause first before you can have the effect. And therefore, the independent variable should precede, come first before the dependent variable. Okay, please.
Bài nói thứ hai, tức là đối với lại biến số X và Y thì nó có bốn điều kiện ha. Bây giờ mình phải trình bày hai điều kiện trước. Với cái function là X và S và B thì mọi thay đổi của X phải dẫn tới sự thay đổi của Y. Tại vì nếu như mà X và khi X thay đổi và Y không thay đổi, tức là hai biến số này nó hoàn toàn không có quan hệ gì với nhau hết. Cái này là cấp 2 rồi ha. Cái thứ hai là X và Y nó phải đi theo quan hệ nhân quả. X là nguyên nhân và Y là kết quả. X phải thay đổi trước và dẫn tới sự thay đổi của Y, chứ không có chuyện là Y thay đổi trước rồi mới dẫn tới sự thay đổi của X nha. Tức là independent variable phải thay đổi trước dependent variable.
Okay, clear?
Rõ.
Did you get what we said? Huh?
Yes,
yes. Okay, clear. So that's, those are two conditions. There are two more for the cause for the change to occur. The third condition is no other factor should be a possible cause of the change in the dependent variable. I'm sorry about that. No other factor should be a possible cause of the change in the dependent variable. Hence, the researcher should control for the effects of the variables. In other words, before you can measure, let's make this more a specific motivation to train. Okay? To train, to learn. Okay? So, in other words, what you're saying is you should control for this. That before you ask people if they want to be trained some more, nobody should be promoted. Because if one has been recently promoted, it could have a different effect on the person. And therefore, you should control for all of this, that nothing will interfere on the dependent variable and on the dependent variable as well. Okay? No change, no other factor should be a possible cause of the change in the dependent variable. The researcher should control. In other words, if these are your independent variables, there should be no change of this to affect motivation when you measure it. For that change to be determined clearly. Okay? No other factor, which means other than this, there should be no other factor that will change the motivation. Other than this. So there should be no other factor except all of this. So control this and control other factors that might change the motivation. Okay? The fourth is a logical explanation or a theory is needed and it must explain why the independent variable affects the dependent variable. You get that from the literature. If researchers say that those factors cause change in the motivation of people, then that's what you might want to find out as well. Okay?
Please. Quay hướng tại cái điều kiện số 3 nha. Là theo cái điều kiện số 3 đó là không có cái yếu tố nào khác làm ảnh hưởng đến y ngoài x. Tức là chẳng hạn như các anh chị define yếu tố y của chúng ta trong cái quá trình chúng ta nghiên cứu là motivation to train. Thì chỉ có 4 yếu tố này là compensation, promotion, confidence và recognition ảnh hưởng tới motivation to train mà thôi. Chúng ta không còn yếu tố nào khác có thể là ảnh hưởng tới cái này. Bởi vì nếu như mà chúng ta không assume là không còn yếu tố nào khác thì khi đó chúng ta không có xác định được mối quan hệ chính xác giữa 4 cái chuyện này và thằng này. Mọi người rõ không ạ? Tức là phải be sure là ngoài 4 yếu tố này không còn cái gì ảnh hưởng tới thằng này nữa. Tức là trong một cái function như thế này, các chị đi vào S cộng B thì ngoài X ra không có cái gì thay đổi trong đây khác làm thay đổi lại kết quả của Y. Clear ha? Và cái điều kiện cuối cùng là buộc phải có lý thuyết giải thích về cái này, chẳng hạn như là according to ông A, B gì đó thì cái promotion là một yếu tố ảnh hưởng tới motivation to learn further. Tức là phải có một cái ông đã viết về cái đề tài này thôi. Nếu không thì làm sao mà các anh chị biết được là promotion có ảnh hưởng tới cái việc motivation hay không?
Okay, now let's take a look at this very simple example. Now you will see here the relationship between the independent variable, which is new product success, and the dependent variable, which is the stock market price. In other words, if your new product success is very high, then the same product might have a rise, increase in stock market price. In other words, your stocks in the company, because introduced in the market, you can imagine Apple, when they introduced iPad, from 5 billion sales, they rose to 32 billion sales. What do you think happened to the stocks of Apple? it also became very high, which means that people who bought stocks from Apple earlier and at a lesser price were happy because their stock suddenly, if they bought it for, let's say, $20 and it rose to $70, then they have a gain already. And if the stock price goes up, what do you think is the company's profit? Very high. So the relationship is success in the new product will also mean success in the stock market price. It will go up. It means that you can define success in sales. You don't have to define it. In other words, the new product sales might be up. Okay. The only effect it will have on the stock market will only also be up. But imagine if instead of this, you can imagine if, supposing you have a new product, but instead of being successful, it goes down. What do you think will happen to this? It will also go down. So that is the relationship shown by this diagram, that a success in a new product will also give rise to stock market price. So very clear, this is the independent variable, that's the dependent variable. Okay?
Clear.
Okay, another example. The independent variable, which is managerial values, and the dependent variable, which is power distance. What do you mean by power distance? Okay, this diagram is between the independent variable, managerial values, and the dependent variable, which is power distance. Managerial values, which is the IV independent variable, explain the variance in the power distance. What do you mean by power distance? You can define it. Find that in a business dictionary. And then you can define it as you use it in the research. So we are just showing the relationship between this independent variable to that dependent variable. In other words, you're saying that your value as a manager will have an effect on power distance. In other words, where you go and how far you go, your values will influence your power. Which is true. And you get that from your literature. But if you do not read the literature, you know it's right. But you cannot explain it. You only can explain it when you do research and you read your related literature properly to identify your variables. And that's like what we said, your independent variables comes first. You have your values already before you even became an employee. And how fast you went up the ladder in the promotions until you get to where you are is influenced in part, of course in part, by your managerial values. People love you. You have a very efficient and effective management style. Then your power distance or your how much you will go will also be determined by that.
Thế này là một cái ví dụ về cái giữa financial value là cái cách của một người quản lý xác định cái value của mình, cái giá trị của mình ảnh hưởng tới cái power distance. Power distance hay OP giống như là cao là sếp sếp có sợ chị hay không, hay là nó coi chị là một người leader hay là nó coi chị là boss kiểu như vậy, thì cái này thì thực sự là cái của OP của mình ha. Thì cái này chỉ là cái ví dụ của cái independent variable là cái financial value ảnh hưởng như thế nào tới cái power distance thôi, nó chỉ là cái ví dụ thôi.
Next. Please check your handouts because I think managerial values was made into dependent variable. It's an error. Can you check that? Look for the point of figure 5.2 and change the managerial down below. hear about this IV. I think in your handout it is DV. That's wrong. Okay, change it. Okay, now we will learn about what moderating variables is. Earlier we were saying that you have to control the independent variables from other variables that will influence the change, that could affect the change. Okay? Now the moderating variable is one that has strong contingent effect on the independent variable relationship. That is the presence of a third variable, which we call the moderating variable, modifies the original relationship between the independent and the dependent variable. This becomes clear through the following examples. Okay, the moderating variable is explained further through these examples. Okay, you want to explain to this?
Can you go back? Moderating variable nó là một cái yếu tố mà nó ảnh hưởng liên tục tới cái independent variable, và cái nó ảnh hưởng trực tiếp tới cái mối quan hệ giữa x và y, cái này thì nó là một nguyên tố khác ở bên ngoài cái function của mình và ảnh hưởng trực tiếp tới quan hệ giữa x và y, tức là thay đổi mối quan hệ này ha. Thì giờ mình sẽ go through cái example mình coi ra như thế nào.
Now here is an example of what we mean when there is a moderating variable that will affect the relationship between the independent and the dependent variables. Okay, let's read number one. A research study indicates that the better quality of the training program is in an organization and the greater the growth needs of the employees. In other words, quality of training program and the growth needs of the employees. No? These are the variables where the need to develop and grow the job is strong. The greater is their willingness to learn new ways of doing things. Okay? Another research study indicates that the willingness of the employees to learn new ways of doing things is not influenced by the quality of the training program offered by the organization to all people without any distinction. Only those with high growth needs seem to have the yearning to learn to do new things through specialized training. This is how it works.
Thank you.
căng mà ăn.
Okay. One more mango. The mango is very good. What is this?
Sugar.
Okay.
Here,
the ginger
is
all sugar.
Smell.